He would have liked to capitalize on that turnover as well, but York gets the puck into the neutral zone.
Lions struggling a little bit to get it out of their own end here. This could cost them if they don't fix this.
Rebecca Bond trying to take the puck out of their zone, but again, U of T there to break up that attempt. And Marley McLaughlin will ice the puck for U of T, and the puck will come all the way back into U of T's zone to the left of Nicole Kasteris. Face-off controlled by U of T in their end, but York is trying to get it back, and they almost do, but U of T gets it back up and into the neutral zone. Wilson takes that one back, looking for another goal on the game for her. Dumps it into the corner. And U of T gets it back out, and once again, into the York Lions zone. Lisa Stathopoulos back there to get it up ice for Chloe Milano. Doing a little dangling out there, trying to get something going, and she tries to get a shot on goal, but it's blocked by the U of T defense.
Well, you know, Milano did a great job of getting open along the wing there. Great effort by her teammates to get her the centering pass. Just couldn't break it into the zone.
And here's Andrea Joyce now, and another great opportunity for York. Nicole Kasteris shuts the door, though.
York putting on a lot of pressure right here. This could be a time for them to capitalize and take a 2-0 lead into the intermission.
Brooke had a really good opportunity there to keep it out of their end, but it went right through her legs, and it ended up trickling right on goal, but Megan Lee there to make sure that no mistakes happened. And U of T back in the neutral zone trying to get something going for themselves before the end of this period. And York takes it in the corner. Bringing it around the left side, and a lead pass for Kim Ramcharan again. And she can't get the shot off. Fans on it. Great defense there by U of T. Assistant captain Marley McLaughlin for U of T, making sure that Ramcharan does not get a shot on net. And now U of T trying to get it out, but York takes over right in front of the goal. And they still have it, and a great shot, a great opportunity there by York. But again, Nicole Kasteris so far having a great game. She's a pretty tall goaltender, actually. She's 5'8", Adam, and that's pretty big for a girl, to be honest.
Very, 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 very tall on her, especially on skates, very close to 6 feet on skate. So she does cover up a lot of the net when she's standing. She does make sure that there's not a lot of room up high when her opponents are shooting on her.
And U of T will control that face-off. And they're going to try and get it back and regroup, but York is really, really forechecking hard. We have 1 minute left to play in this period. U of T fighting hard here to try and get a goal before time runs out. Great job by the York defense to clear the puck out from in front of the net and try and stave off U of T before this minute runs out. Lots of traffic in front of the net, and now York comes up with it into the neutral zone here. Lisa Stathopoulos has the puck all on her own. One white jersey, five blue, six including the goalie. Tries for a centering pass, and it gets through. Oh, she keeps it in. Oh, and U of T finally getting it out into the neutral zone. But York, what a great opportunity there. With 10 seconds just winding down, U of T will have one more shot on goal. Megan Lee will glove that one for the whistle. And with 4.3 seconds left in the first period, we will have a face-off to the left of Megan Lee.
Yeah, You know, Jess, York has done a fantastic job thus far controlling the puck in their own end. That's going to be a key factor for them if they want to win this game tonight.
And that'll do it for the first period. The York Lions lead the U of T Varsity Blues 1-0 on a goal from Christy Wilson. We'll be back with some second period action in 15 minutes.
the Domino's by my house.
Welcome back to Canlan Ice Sports Arena. The York Lions hosting the U of T Varsity Blues. We're kicking off the second period here with a whistle. Stopping play, which gives me time to tell you that the York Lions are up 1-0 on the U of T Varsity Blues, thanks to a goal from Christy Wilson, who leads the York Lions in goals this year, and will continue to do so if she keeps up the way she's been playing lately. A fresh sheet of ice out there for the ladies. And U of T coming out strong so far. Trying to get a goal early in this one and switch the momentum, but York has other ideas. Here's Wilson again breaking in over the line, but too many blue jerseys there for her to get in on net. Oh, Megan Lee tossed the first shot aside, and now the second one. A great save by her right there. And U of T cannot keep it in. It gets right by April Loya, or Loya rather. Loya. And she'll chase it right back and try and get something going here for the Varsity Blues. York right there to pick it up in the neutral zone. Gets it back to Finlay. Rihanna Langford brings it up into the U of T zone for York. The U of T will take over. Passing it up to the captain, number 27, Kelly O'Hanlon, and there is the equalizer, Stacy O. Nets one for the U of T Varsity Blues, and we are all tied up here under 2 minutes into this game, or sorry, into this period, rather.
Just a great passing play by the University of Toronto Varsity team right there. Quick cross-crease pass right in front of Megan Lee. Not enough time for her to get across to make that pad save. She came very close, but very good goal for University of Toronto.
And there goes her second straight shutout bout.
U of T goals scored by number 27, Kelly O'Hanlon.
Oh, it was assisted, rather, by number 2, Stacey O. And the captain actually netted that one for U of T. O'Hanlon, number 27. And they're looking for another one here, but Lee keeps it out this time. Ooh, a physical play in the corner there. U of T trying to control it, looking for some kind of play here to get them up on York and take the lead for the first time in this game. York's going to take over and dump that back into the neutral zone, and they look pretty tired out there. And despite that, I thought they were going to go off. They take one more shot on goal. Stephanie Doveston takes a shot, and they will head to the bench and get a quick change in here. It really is a good old hockey game, and that face-off is controlled in the corner slightly by the York Lions, but they're battling for it with a few blue shirts back there as well. And York still controls that one, gets it to the back, and it actually comes out right in front of the net for York, and they can't put it in.
First penalty of the game coming up right here.
We are going to have a hooking penalty here. And it's going to go against U of T, so the York Lions are going to go to the power play, Adam. Let's see what they can do with this one.
Well, Jess, it's the first power play of the game for either team. Not a lot to watch for here. We haven't seen either team on the power play yet so far, but look for the defense to get very involved with this one.
Marie-Claire
Genot. The defenseman for U of T taking that penalty. Taking that hooking call, and York looking pretty good so far on the power play. They've got it in the U of T zone now. cycling the puck around to the point, centered for Brooke. A backhand, trying to center it for Wilson again. Bond has the puck on the point, back to Brooke. A centering pass there for Chloe Milano, just can't dump it in.
Very good job by York there on that offensive chance, doing a great job of playing around the box set up by U of T.
Chloe Milano again, she's in there. She's really looking for it, the captain of the York Lions, and you can see why. She's really gritty, trying to get a handle on the puck while they have it in the U of T zone. Now U of T is going to take over, but York's still pressuring. They're not going to give it up easy on this power play. A backhanded centering pass, but all there is there are blue shirts.
U of T will go for a line change, a real quick line change here. They looked very tired on that last offensive drive by York University.
Well, they are on the penalty kill, so that doesn't really surprise me. And York was putting the pressure on something awful there. I guess not something awful. Putting the pressure on. That's not really an awful thing. And they're still doing it here, cycling the puck around from the point to the corner and back to center. Back to the point, looking for a shot. Oh, a shot right on. Looking, they've got a lot of traffic there in front of Nicole Caceres. She didn't need to see that one because the traffic blocked the puck from getting through.
Lions players doing a great job of on-ice communication here. Megan Finley pinched one of the forwards, drop back very quickly. That's a good sign by from the York team.
York trying to keep it in here, and they won't. U of T just chipping it into the neutral zone, and she's going to be offside trying to take it back in too quickly before her teammates could come out of the zone. So we're going to have a face-off just outside, or just inside, rather. Or sorry, just outside to the right of Caceres. Just outside the U of T zone. And York's going to control that face-off. But they can't get a controlled pass over to the wing to Bond. And U of T is going to take over with a great opportunity there. But Megan Lee was with it all the way, and she saw that one, keeping it out of the net.
Great job by Megan Lee. Just saw that puck coming all the way through. Made sure she got down on her down on the, in the butterfly position. Made sure she got that one.
And York comes out of the corner with the puck, taking it right back. Oh, and they drops it back and causes a breakaway. Wow, what a great defensive play there by Jamie Andreese. She prevented a goal by U of T there by laying her body out on the line. Milano back in the corner trying to help York come out of the corner with this one and prevent U of T from getting another shot. Penalty long over. We're back at even strength. And they're going to call that one a draw. York's going to make a quick line change on this one. They're going to face off just to the left of Megan Lee. York just about won that one, but U of T took it right over. A shot right there by Marley McLaughlin, but it doesn't make it through. Too much traffic, and here comes York bringing it up into the neutral zone. Just onside, and they score! What a beautiful goal there by Kiri Langford. Unbelievable wrist shot right over the glove of Nicole Caceres, top corner. What a beauty that one was, Adam.
Absolutely. Kiri Langford just picked up the puck in her own end. His end-to-end rush right there, split the defense right in the zone, and just took a beautiful wrist shot right over the goaltender, Nicole Caceres. Beautiful shot, beautiful goal. We have one heck of a game going on here.
So it's 2-1 for the York Lions now in the second period. That was an unassisted goal by her as she broke into the zone all alone for that beautiful wrister. Really giving the York Lions something to work for here and some momentum as they take their second lead of the game. U of T looking to answer back. A shot from the blue line, but far too much traffic to get through to Megan Lee. Megan Lee. York just really putting the pressure on now, and they're coming out of the neutral zone with the puck. Another shot right on Kasteris, but this time she sees it all the way, and it hits her right in the tee. No problem saving that one. Wow. Oh, that was just about another goal by York. I really thought that was in, Adam, but the ref calls it off.
Looked very close from up here. Erin Cameron almost had the goal number 17 on the York Lions. Looked to just barely miss the net on that one, but we're going to have a face-off outside to the right of the U of T goaltender.
Well, Kasteris will have to keep her eyes on this one because York is going to come right back at her, I can tell. They are really fighting for this, and Kim Ramcharan trying to fight for the puck, but quite a bit smaller than the forwards and the defense from U of T. It really looked like a much bigger team, although the skill level for York is really coming out here, and they are proving that they can compete just as well.
Absolutely, Jess. I know York came out into this period looking like a completely different team than they did in the first period. Lots more energy, lots more focus, and a lot of more control over the puck this period than they had in the first.
They seem to have quite a bit more confidence, I agree. They've got a little bit more spring in their step after they got a period under their belts here. And they're looking to try and get it out of the zone, but U of T is not allowing that to happen. Sonia Weidenfelder dropped her stick there, otherwise she would have had a great opportunity to make a play happen for U of T, but instead... Well, Day here with another great opportunity for York, but an amazing defensive play there by Kristen Barbara to strip her of the puck. And they bring it into the U of T zone, but unfortunately for York, they brought it in offside.
You know, just since the end of the first period, we saw a little bit of rough stuff right at the buzzer at the end of the first. We've seen the physicality level pick up here in the second period. So look for both teams to start pushing each other around just a little bit more. May be a key factor in this afternoon's game.
Face-off controlled easily by the York Lions, and they try and get it around into the U of T zone, but they're battling for it at the blue line. York again, just onside, keeping it in, trying for another high wrister, but that is blocked by the U of T defense, and now U of T coming. Callie Boyzik with a shot right on Megan Lee, but she controls that one. And again, Boyzik trying to get another shot on goal, but that one is tipped up and over the net and into the left corner. U of T really fighting hard here for it. Back in the corner with it is Leela. Leela Chan-Curry really trying to put the pressure on over there and grab the puck, but York's too powerful, and here's another breakaway opportunity. What a good chance there for Lisa Stathopoulos.
Split the D, beat the D, but couldn't beat the goaltender.
Yeah, Kasteris seems to be getting her groove back here now after letting in that second goal. U of T now dumping it into the neutral zone, but York taking over right away. And the shot goes off the leg of Caitlin Bannon. U of T having to battle for it in their own zone here. But York doing a great job of keeping it in so far. They just need to get a few more shots on goal, or at least I'm sure they'd like to. They lose the puck behind the net, and U of T takes over, trying to bring it back into the neutral zone. But York somehow keeps it onside. That was a close call. Looked like she kept it onside, rather, by the blade of her skate. Lindsay Brooke keeping the puck out of harm's way there. And Kim Ramcharan trying to find it between the skates. And now there's a large puck battle going on in the corner to the left of Kasteris, who just about saw a bouncing puck go into the net there, but she watched it go by the net right in front of her. Now U of T with the puck behind their own net, looking to regroup, but heavy forechecking by the York Lions. And again, they take it right over in the neutral zone. Hurst and Barbara handling that one. But she couldn't handle this one, and U of T gets it back out. Although, again, York there. They seem to be everywhere right now. U of T just can't find blue shirts.
Absolutely, Jess. It seems that the York Lions are just doing a tremendous job here of watching the play happen, reading what what U of T is trying to do, and just following through on that. And we have a delayed penalty call coming up here against the York Lions. We'll see what it is.
So U of T will now go to their first power play of the game. That looks like Somerville, Dana Somerville, getting the penalty, number 25, the defenseman for the York Lions. So U of T will try their hand at a penalty kill, at a power play. That penalty was 2 minutes for roughing by Dana Somerville. And U of T looking to capitalize on it immediately, but York gets it out and into the neutral zone all the way down the ice. And Lisa Stathopoulos chasing the puck on the penalty kill forecheck, and a great job. And Dreese with a shot right on. And Kasteris is there to turn that one away. What a great battle going on the penalty kill here, even by York. They're really trying to get an offensive opportunity even on the penalty kill. And York is going to go down two. York is going to take another penalty here, I believe, for cross-checking at him. And now they are going to give U of T a two-man advantage.
Yeah, Jess,
for a minute and 3 seconds.
It's an interference call for York. That was one of those penalties that you could say is a good penalty. Saved a goal right there, a potential goal from happening right there. But nonetheless, York is going down two men now. Number 22, Kiri Langford, who actually had the second goal, taking the penalty.
Yeah, that's true. She's not. Hopefully, they don't. Well, for her sake, she doesn't not redeem herself here, and they score as a result. But York is going to have their work cut out for them to keep the puck out of the net here. I thought I saw her cross-check the U of T player into the net, which was a dangerous-looking play. It was a dangerous interference call, and the puck is going to be deflected up and over the net and out of play.
Great block there by number 4, Chloe Milano, just doing a great job of getting in front of that puck, making sure that her team has every opportunity to get that defense involved.
They're going
to
switch up the penalty killers just a little bit here, as Lisa Stathopoulos is going to come in for York with 43 seconds remaining and a two-man advantage for U of T. McLaughlin passing it over to her defense partner. Kirsty Risley back to McLaughlin. Back to Risley, who takes a shot right on Megan Lee, but she's there. Leela Chan-Curry tries for the shot, but York clears it out as the shot is blocked. And Stathopoulos takes off the bench after just coming on, and we got a new set of penalty killers on. Bond, Milano, and Andreese for York. That's right, only three so far, but in 2-1 second, the first penalty of the York Lions is over, so we now have a 5-on-4.
Great job by the York Lions killing off that 5-on-3. Relentless effort by the forwards and the defense there. Just getting in front of shots, getting it right out of their zone.
York sending Kim Ramcharan onto the ice, and again, Milano showing why she's the captain of this team. A great effort by her, but unfortunately, the U of T is going to put the puck in the back of the net anyway. And you could see Milano just drop her head in anguish there, seeing that puck go in after laying her body on the line to block the shot. And U of T has tied this game at 2 goals apiece with 5 minutes and 44 seconds left in the second period.
You know, Jess, you mentioned Chloe Milano's second block shot of the night, doing a great job as captain, you know, being the leader there, showing her team what to do, you know, leading by example, I guess you could say, doing a great job. Unfortunately, didn't pay off in their favor, but look for York University to get right back in this one.
Langford taking the faceoff for York, and they just about controlled it. Amanda Ricker, number 20 for U of T, scoring that goal and tying this game at 2. So it looked to take the wind a little bit out of the York Lions' sails based on the reaction of Chloe Milano. And U of T looking to continue the putting daggers in the coffin here. Taylor Day with a great opportunity on Megan Lee, but couldn't capitalize. And now here's York bringing it up into the neutral zone. And just offside.
Offside call by the referees. The displeasure of number 16, Andrea Joyce. Clearly looked like she, to her, clearly looked like she was onside. Not very happy with that call. She throws her arms up in disbelief.
Well, to be honest, Adam, I actually thought she was onside as well, so I can understand her frustration. The puck gets caught up in the referee's skate. And U of T ends up coming up with it, dumping it into the neutral zone. But York there to get it right back into U of T zone. And that's going to be batted all the way down the ice and behind Megan Lee. U of T controlling it behind the net, and they look like they're really getting their groove back here as well. Their passes are starting to be on. They're battling hard forward in the corner right now, and York controls it. Lindsay Cochran trying to get it out of their zone. And finally, Kim Ramcharan does it. She is all over the ice tonight. Her and Milano are really showing great leadership. And you know what? They're two of the smallest players out there, but they might have the biggest hearts.
Absolutely. Doing a great job, both of them. Just doing a great job helping out their team, doing everything they can possibly do to get their team a win.
And here's Wilson now back on the ice. I haven't heard much from her in this period. Rebecca Bond taking the puck into the U of T zone. Battling forward in the corner and coming out with it is Milano, with a backhand centering pass to Lisa Stathopoulos, but too much traffic in front of the net for her. Sarah Conway now trying to get something going for York. Lots of pressure in the U of T zone, and they are going to try and get it out, but Barbara keeps it in. And finally, U of T gets it back out into the neutral zone, trying to get down the ice. Captain Kelly O'Hanlon handling that one in the neutral zone. And now York once again trying to regroup. Lisa Stathopoulos passing one up to Wilson. She's tripped up just about trying to get a shot, or rather that was not Wilson, it was Chloe Milano. York can't keep it in. But lots of pressure, and York is going to get another penalty here, Adam, as the arm of the referee goes up. And that is once again going to be an interference call, I believe.
Yeah, Jess, number 16, Andrea.
Or holding, actually,
Andrea
Adam.
Joyce not too happy with that one, but clearly held on to her opponent right there.
Yeah, she did.
So
a little a bear hug from behind, clearly holding call.
Slams the box door as she gets in there. Not very happy with that one. Hopefully her team can kill this one off.
Well, they're really going to need to, because with the firepower that U of T has, they're going to have trouble getting back into the game if they let U of T go up by another goal. Oh, York just trying to backhand it out of the zone there, and they just can't do it. Another backhand try there by Taylor Day for U of T. Too much traffic in front of the net. Now it's on the point. U of T cycling the puck. Number 12, April Loya, trying for a goal there, but that one gets deflected. U of T with the puck behind the net now. Callie Boysick bringing it up to the point. And York just finally gets it out. Give them a little bit of a break and a little bit of a change. But Ramcharan is out there making sure that no mistakes happen on the change. She's really putting herself out there. She's got to be tired. And Lee is just battling to keep this puck out of the net, and she does it.
You know, Jess, that was a really close call. Looked from here, looked to be right on the line. Referee quickly gets right behind the net, makes sure that that puck does not slide in. No goal there.
I'm sure that Lee was pretty happy with a quick whistle there. But she battled to keep it out, and getting some props there by Rebecca Bond, who gives her a little bit of a pad tap, saying thanks a lot for keeping us in this one for now with just under 2 minutes left in the second period. They really needed that stop. U of T again controlling that faceoff in the York zone. It's going over to McLaughlin now, who passes it up for their captain, Kelly O'Hanlon. O'Hanlon with a shot right on Lee, and Lee is there to make the pad save, and another pad save on the corner by Lee. Lots of shots coming her way right now by U of T with a minute and 20 seconds left in the second period.
You know, Megan Lee very quick on those rebounds, making sure that the U of T team does not get many great chances to pot one in on the rebound there.
Yeah, three quick saves there by her, really helping York keep it in here. And they are looking tired on this penalty kill unit. Milano struggling to get off the ice as they dump the puck into the zone. And Langford.
Very strong kill there by the Lions as number 16, Andrea Joyce, now out of the box.
York bringing it back up into the neutral zone. And the penalty over there now at even strength. So they're trying to get something going with just under 40 seconds left to go. Andrea Joyce battling in the corner with Marley McLaughlin for the puck. And just about a shot right on there again for Joyce. And into the neutral zone. York can't keep it in. Time winding down. Just under 20 seconds left. Another chance here for U of T. But number 7, Reagan Danford, shoots it wide.
That one deflected off the stick of Megan Finley. Nearly confused goaltender Megan Lee right there, but very close.
And Finley will end the period with the puck behind her own zone. It is 2-2 at Canlan Ice Sports Arena. The York University Lions are hosting the U of T Varsity Blues. And that does it for the second period. We'll be back with third period action all tied up. We'll see you in 15 minutes. Welcome back to Canlan Ice Sports Arena, where the York University Lions are taking on the U of T Varsity Blues, and we are bringing you third period action. I'm Jessica Osterhan, joined by Adam Nightingale, and in 20 seconds, we will be doing the puck drop for the third period. We're all tied up 2-2 here at Canlan Ice Sports. And it was a much more exciting second period than it was a first period, Adam.
Absolutely, Jess. Lots of back and forth action between these two great offensive teams here that we've seen so far. Both teams getting extremely good scoring chances. That's why we have a tie game here at 2-2 entering the third period, but both goaltenders have stood on their head.
Absolutely. We'll see if we can do it here this time. The face-off, the opening face-off anyway, won by U of T. But York took it over in the neutral zone, and now they're still battling for it as U of T backhands it into the York zone in towards New York goaltender Megan Lee. York gets it out of their end and into the neutral zone, but McLaughlin sends it right back in and a shot right on Megan Lee. She handles that one easily and hands it off to her defense, who gets it back up into the neutral zone. Battling forward on the right side of the boards there, and York comes up with it. U of T dumping it right back in behind the net. Curie Langford with the puck here for York, chipping it into the neutral zone. But U of T taking over, trying to put the pressure on here. Kelly Hanlon, the captain, passing it off to April Loya, who gets a shot, but that one is deflected up and out of play into the netting.
And Jess, we've seen a lot of offensive and defensive success from April Loya tonight. She's the tallest member of the University of Toronto team, standing at 6 foot tall. She's done a lot of strength in her shot. We've seen that from her tonight so far.
Absolutely, and she looks pretty tall out there on the ice compared to everyone else. And Megan Lee again, that puck just about trickled up over her pad and in. She managed to keep it out. So there will be a face-off just to the left of Megan Lee. And the York Lions winning that one. Kristen Barbara takes that one behind the net and into the neutral zone. But U of T will take the puck from there and dump it right back into the York zone. Kim Ramcharan out there for York again, showing some true grit. She's got the puck now in front of the net for Erin Cameron.
U of T doing a great job of pressuring the Lions in their own end, trying to force them to make a bad turnover, which would capitalize on a goal. They've done that already this so far tonight, resulting in their second goal.
Barbara for York, bringing it up behind the U of T net, trying to get an opportunity, but she's surrounded there by Blue Shirts. And Milano, Chloe Milano, taking charge in the U of T zone, trying to get York an opportunity here, and Wilson looking for her second goal of the night.
You know, Jess, we've seen a lot from Captain Chloe Milano so far this afternoon.
Looking for another goal, Milano, another shot. Sorry about that, Adam, just a great opportunity for York there.
She's been driving to the net all game and looks to hopefully get one in the back of the net very shortly.
A collision here, just about at center ice, and doesn't look too good. The two players who collided there coming off a little bit slowly. And that'll be an icing call against York University, and the puck is going to come all the way back to the right of Megan Lee. York controlling the face-off. Number 24, Lindsay Brooke, with the puck behind the net, looking to get something going here. Passing straight up to Andrea Joyce, trying to split the D there, but they take care of her. Hey, And that will now be an... That'll be an icing call against U of T. It'll come all the way back. And again, the referee calling them on the line change there, Adam. You're not allowed to make a line change if you ice the puck. So that line will come right back out on the ice and take a face-off to the left of Nicole Kasteris, the starting goalie for U of T. And York wins the face-off in the zone and just about lets it out of the zone. They couldn't decide who was going to take that puck at him, and it just about cost them this opportunity, which, well, now they've just turned it over in front of the net to McLaughlin, and she's going to dump it into the York zone. So finally U of T can get a change.
Well, you know, Jess, that was a pure example of poor communication on the York Lions part right there. Not really communicating on who was going to get that puck. Almost resulted in an offensive break for U of T.
Exactly. Just not even be having the puck in the zone. It's a tough thing to keep the puck in the zone against a team like U of T. So for them to have let it out on a sloppy play like that, it doesn't really look good on them. So it's pretty lucky that they kept it in. And I assume that their communication will be a little bit better from here on out. And just a trickling puck towards Megan Lee there, and she tosses that one aside. York gets the puck out of their zone into the neutral zone, and U of T trying to make a play happen there. Battling for the puck in the left corner. And a backhand shot onto Lee. She deflects that wide. Another shot, and that's deflected just behind the net, so not on. Lee not having to stop that one. York really trying to regroup here and get something going, passing it up to center ice to Stephanie Doveston. He was trying to handle that in the neutral zone but couldn't, and now the puck is back into the York zone. And Aaron Cameron couldn't handle that pass. Puck now coming just outside U of T zone to the left of Kasteris. And U of T will handle that face off, but York breaking it up right away.
Lions doing a very good job here of causing turnovers right that York has sent up the middle, doing a great job of, U of T has sent up the middle. York doing a great job of picking those passes off and turning them into scoring opportunities.
Both teams looking for scoring opportunities at every chance that they possibly can here. And Andrea Joyce bringing in the puck for a beautiful second opportunity goal there by the York Lions. Picking up her own rebound. I believe that was number 25. Or no, rather it is not. It is number 21. I unfortunately cannot see her number because her jersey is tucked in. So number 2, number 22, Kiri Langford with the goal for York.
Langford, her second of the game here tonight. Great, great effort on the rebound there. Andrea Joyce, not known for her scoring ability, more for her physicality, gets a great opportunity there, and Kiri Langford follows up on the rebound.
That puck is going to go off a stick and out of play into the netting. I'm finding it really difficult to see a lot of the numbers down on the ice and the names. All the girls with their long hair cover up their names, and with their jerseys tucked in, it's very difficult to read the numbers.
You know, Jess, athletes, they have their superstitions, so I think they win on this one.
I'm pretty sure that Langford will keep her jersey tucked in after that one. And another! That looked like a goal there by Christy Wilson, and if it was a goal and they're calling it back, I believe it'll be called back because of a high stick. It looked like it made contact over the crossbar. But I think the ref is just saying that Kasteris kept it out.
looked very, very close from up here. But again, just like you mentioned, if it was being called back, definitely was for a high stick. That was a really high knockdown.
Wilson with a little bit of a blind shot there right on Caceres. Looked like she was going to, looked like it was supposed to be a pass, but it just kind of went right through and ended up on goal. Face off eventually controlled by U of T here in their own zone, trying to get it out. But you're keeping it in and getting their own opportunity here after going up 3-2 on this powerhouse U of T team. Oh, Langford passes it over there to Andrea Joyce, who just couldn't get the shot off. She couldn't handle the pass. Now battling forward in the corner is Barbara with an odd angle shot that almost landed right on goal as well. York keeping it in their zone, but U of T finally taking it into the neutral zone and trying to get something going with 13 minutes remaining in this third period.
You know, Jess, that's been the big difference maker in this game so far, that the York University Lions have gotten offensive contributions from both their forwards and their defensemen. Number 20, Kristen Barber, like you mentioned before, with that shot on goal. Defenseman doing a great job of chipping in on the offense.
A shot there by Taylor Day right on Megan Lee. But she was right there, not allowing that one to go in. And she knows that she can't let anything in from here on out if she wants to keep her team in this. It's a huge win for York if they do take this one, given the rivalry between these two schools. Their football had their Red and Blue Bowl this year, and U of T won that one. So it would be sweet if York could take this one. And that shot just wide of the net. Megan Lee let that one go, knowing that it was going to the side. And now York battling to get the puck out of their zone, and they do. Passing it up to Milano, who's trying to split the D, but they're just too much for her. April Loya, at 6 feet tall, is no match, or is a huge match, rather, for Christy Wilson at only 5'9". A shot right on goal there again by number 22, Kiri Langford, looking for her third goal of the night. I'm seeing a lot of firepower coming from some of the smallest players out there for York, including Chloe Milano and Christy Wilson as well. Battling for the puck in the corner, and U of T comes out with it. Trying to backhand it out of their zone, but they keep it in. And looks like there's going to be a penalty coming here. And there is going to be a penalty, and it's going to York. And this is going to take some wind out of their sails, that they're going to have to be on the penalty kill now. It should be a tripping call. Penalty to number 26, Sarai Witte. And she is sending her team to the penalty kill. U of T is going to try and capitalize on this power play, but York controlling the faceoff and getting it right out into the neutral zone right off the bat, killing off a few seconds at the very beginning of this power play for U of T.
And Jess, York Lions, you can hear them from all the way up here, not very happy with what just transpired right off the draw, what appeared to be a clear-cut holding, what should have been a clear-cut holding penalty against U of T. You can hear the coach not very happy with that one. That could come back and hurt them.
Well, if the refs heard them, perhaps there will be a makeup call later on, Adam. You never know. It happens. U of T trying to get something going here. Lisa Stathopoulos is really putting the pressure on as well. And Ram Turan back on. He's been playing great offensively and defensively for York, who are just trying to save a goal from going into their net here, as they're up by one goal almost halfway through this third period. C. Stacy O can't handle the pass across ice, and the U of T Varsity Blues are offside. So they're going to come and face off to the right of Megan Lee, just outside of the York University zone. And once again, it is 5-on-4 as York University is on the penalty kill right now. And U of T handles the faceoff, trying to get something going here, and dumping it back in behind the York net. Caitlin Makawa passing it back into the corner, back to Makawa. Over to number 14, Marley McLaughlin. But York doing a great job to get the puck out so they can get a quick change on for their penalty killers.
And just number 22, Kiri Lang, for just getting that one out of the zone quickly. We've seen her all over the ice tonight so far, whether it be on the power play or the penalty kill. She seems to be doing everything she can to help her team win this one.
Absolutely, Adam. And you know what? It really seems like they all know that they all have to step up and help in different ways, especially right now with time winding down on the penalty, which it now is. So we're back to even strength as Christy Wilson and Dana Somerville come back onto the ice, or rather Kirsten Barbara come back on the ice for York. So U of T unable to capitalize on that power play. York turns it over in their own zone, but is able to control it, and now it's a 3-on-1 for York University. Oh, it's too bad for Lisa Stathopoulos. Couldn't handle the pass across ice. Still pressuring in front of the net. Christy Wilson battling for the puck, but U of T is going to take it out into the neutral zone. Leela Chan Curry bringing the puck up and dumping it into the York zone so U of T can get a change off. And now a lead pass. York controlling it behind the U of T zone, or behind the U of T net here rather, and a shot right on by Langford again. Looking for the hat trick. That would be a great way to follow up Megan Lee's 3-0 shutout victory in their last game, for Langford to get a hat trick in this one. York really scrambling here, trying to keep the momentum away from U of T. As Joyce shoots the puck in right on Kasteris. Battling for the puck in the neutral zone. Both teams are, and U of T tries to dump it into the York zone, but the defense is there to try and keep it out, and they're battling for it again. U of T passing it back into their zone, looking to regroup, but Ramcharan on the forecheck here. Doveston's going to try and go get that one, and they just can't keep it in, going right past Megan Finlay there. And U of T looking for an opportunity, but Megan Lee, she sees it all the way, and another great save by the York goaltender.
You know, Jess, Megan Lee's just done everything she can tonight to stop all the shots that she's faced. Obviously not the shutout she was obviously hoping for, like she did against the Ryerson Rams, but she's done a fantastic job so far.
That's right, Adam. She's done a really great job here for York, and they have to against a team like this. And now here's another opportunity for Stathopoulos, and we could have a penalty shot here.
Doesn't look like we're going to get a penalty shot, but definitely a tripping call.
She was dragged down there, and unfortunately it wasn't quite enough of a breakaway for a penalty shot on that one for Stathopoulos. But nonetheless, York Lions going on the power play with 7 minutes and 13 seconds left in this game.
Number 12, April Loya, going to the box for U of T on this one. Hustled really hard back to try and break up that play, just couldn't get there in time, and ended up taking the penalty for it.
Well, she might have saved her team a goal there. Another one, Wilson, she was there for the chip-in on that shot. And Chloe Milano, they've got their best players out on the ice right now, and they really want a goal here to try and just keep the game out of U of T's reach. Christy Wilson racing for the puck. And the U of T fans wanted a tripping call there. Chloe Milano. Chloe Milano with the puck just out in front and a shot right on. Trying to stuff it through Nicole Kasteris' legs was Lisa Stathopoulos. But Kasteris closes the door.
Very good opportunity there by the York Lions. Good job of making passes work for them. Puck was laying right in front of the U of T goaltender for about maybe 2 or 3 seconds alone before she jumped on the rebound there. Very close call.
Doveston taking the faceoff for York now.
And there's number 22, Kiri Langford, out there on the power play once again. She's looking for the hat trick tonight.
And they're going to call that one a draw as well. Ruffs will grab the puck, and we'll head for a faceoff. Kiri Langford taking the faceoff for York, and they win that one. Barbara on the point. Back to Barbara here. Into the corner for Doveston. Circling the net. Passes it back to Langford. Back to Barbara. Back to Langford.
It's absolutely a tremendous job here by York so far in this power play. Just cycling the puck, making sure they get the open lanes available for their teammates.
Finley. Back to Barbara. Back to Finley. Who can't handle the pass, and she's being chased down by Reagan Danford of U of T. Just barely keeping it in, Barbara. Doveston can't handle that one, and Langford still battling for it. U of T just cannot get it out here. They're on the penalty kill, and York is all over their zone.
Kiri Langford, her line mates go off for a change. Kiri Langford sees the opportunity to get the jump in on the odd man opportunity there, but she can't capitalize on it.
And now U of T will get a very unlikely opportunity going in 1-on-3, but it actually ended up being a pretty decent chance. But Megan Lee staying tight to the post and making sure that there is no way that puck will go in the net and tie this game up with only 5 minutes left to go.
Very strong effort there by University of Toronto's defenseman April Loya. Jumps right into the box, sees the puck. While she was a 1-on-3 right there, she made a good effort to get the shot on net, and that's all you can really ask for in that case is a shot on net.
Especially from a tired penalty kill squad. She didn't have much legs to get behind it anyway. Now U of T still on the penalty kill, but they are controlling it in the York zone at the moment. Or rather, sorry, the penalty is over. We are at even strength. McLaughlin in the corner. York battling for it, trying to get it out, and they can't do it. Sonia Weidenfelder dumps it into the corner. Christy Risley and Weidenfelder battling for the puck. Kelly O'Hanlon, the captain, coming out with it. Risley again looking for it. A bit of a collision there with Rebecca Bond skating a little bit gingerly to the bench. And Brooke will come out for her, taking the pass at center ice. And dumping in a lead for Langford. Who's battling hard tonight and having and it's really paying off for her with 2 goals. As the York Lions are leading the U of T Varsity Blues by a goal, it's 3-2 with 3.5 minutes left in the game. Lindsay Brooke will touch that one, and U of T will be called for icing, and the faceoff is coming back into the Varsity Blues zone to the left of Nicole Kasteris. Langford taking the face off for York. Taylor Day. York keeping it in the zone, but U of T finally getting it out. Lindsay Brooke calling for the pass there, mishandles it, and just about turns it over to U of T in the York zone. But they eventually dump it all the way down the ice, and now they're going to be called for icing, so it's going to come back into the York zone anyway. Facing off to the left of Megan Lee. Langford again winning the faceoff for York. Andrea Joyce battling for it now. And here comes York taking it up. Fortunately turning it over in the neutral zone. And here comes U of T coming back. Battling for it in the corner, Jacqueline Scheffel. Kristen Barbara bringing it up all alone for York. The only person who doesn't go off for a line change. And a great job there not to turn it over too quickly and wait for her teammates to come out. And now Barbara will go to the bench for a change. Christy Wilson being held up behind the net there.
April Loya with a big bear hug there. Not to the appease of the York University coach. They're looking for a penalty. Not too happy with that one.
That's two missed calls now against them, so I can understand why he's not too happy. Oh, taking it behind the net for U of T. Passing it back up. Sonia Weidenfelder trying to chase. Marley McLaughlin behind the net with the puck, passing it back up. And now she's got the puck again into the neutral zone for O'Hanlon. U of T captain with a shot on Megan Lee, but she's there to toss that one aside. That shot is intercepted by York University, who gets it back into the neutral zone, but now it is dumped behind the York goal. Missed line change there a little bit by U of T. They're getting their girls out a little bit late. But it didn't much matter because they were in the York zone. Now heading into U of T zone. U of T has now pulled their goalie. It's the last minute of play in the third period. Nicole Kasteris is on the bench. U of T has an extra attacker on the ice.
And it definitely seems that U of T has picked up their aggression and speed here a little bit in the last minute of play. You're looking for that tying goal. But the extra man, that's definitely going to be a key factor if they want to win this one.
Battling to keep it in the zone, and they do. York needs to get it out, and then now it is in the neutral zone. But with the extra attacker, U of T is there. And that's going to go over the boards and onto the U of T bench, fired there by April Loya.
Great catch there on the bench by the U of T player. Future, maybe a summer baseball player we got there over there.
Well, Kasteris is going to head back to the goal now with 27.7 seconds left. And U of T is going to call for a timeout now with 27 seconds left. And as far as I could see from up here, it was a good thing because they had too many men on the ice. So they're going to try and formulate some kind of plan here. And it looks to be like it is going to be a 5-on-5 scenario, not a 6-on-5, because Kasteris is going to head back into the goal from what I could see before the timeout. York is just going to look to post up some hardcore defense in this last half a minute and, their win.
I wouldn't be surprised if the coach sends out Kiri Langford out there just in case the U of T coach does decide to pull their goaltender once again, try and get her the hat trick on the night.
Yeah, that would be nice for her, I'm sure. And, I mean, there's no reason not to have her out there with the hot hands that she has had tonight. You definitely want players like that on the ice who are having their best night, and they've got some of their greatest players on the night on the ice now. Milano Langford is out there. So you called that one, Stathopoulos. U of T handles the faceoff, and there goes Kasteris heading to the bench for the sixth attacker.
Just 15 seconds left here in this one.
They're battling for it. And here comes York out with the puck, and it was Milano. And shooting up the ice for Langford, and she just about had a chance for a hat trick in an empty netter. Milano trying to get it to her again. U of T will fire the puck into the back of the York Lions zone, and that is where they will celebrate their second consecutive win and their fourth win of the season over the U of T Varsity Blues, who have just had a five-game winning streak snapped by the York Lions.
Absolutely. What a tremendous game here by both teams, especially on the York Lions part, firing on all cylinders, especially from forward Kiri Langford. Two goals on the night, instrumental in helping her team win this one. And Megan Lee, just absolutely phenomenal, standing on her head the entire game. Great win by York.
Absolutely. Megan really kept them in it. Lee having a great game, and another great performance as well by Christy Wilson, who scored the first goal of the game and still leads the York Lions in goals. We will see you for the York Lions next game versus the Brock Badgers on November the 24th at 2 p.m. There's the winning celebration for your winning York Lions. 3-2, York wins. We'll see you next game. For Adam Nightingale, I'm Jessica Osterhan. Have a great afternoon.
Thanks for watching.